With the release of CL and QL consoles, version 5, we have widened the remote control and monitoring possibilities of these incredible mixers. This is particularly useful when connecting wireless mic systems like Sennheiser's Digital 6000 series. Specifically, CL and QL consoles now offer control and monitoring of Sennheiser's EM6000 Dante models. Let's take a look at how to achieve this. But firstly, we need the correct software and firmware versions. Dante Controller version 4 is needed to make a few settings. We also need Sennheiser's Wireless System Manager, WSM, version 4.4, to update the EM6000 firmware. And the firmware must be version 2.1.9 or newer. Dante firmware for the EM6000 must be version 4.0.7.8 or newer. That's shown in Dante Controller. Then, of course, CL or QL consoles must be using version 5. Now, let's prepare the EM6000. So we're going to focus on the left screen where we can access the system menu. Then there's a few settings we need to take care of. Firstly, the word clock. We should be synchronizing to Dante. Next, the network. And we have a choice here, auto, MDNS, or manual. I'm using auto because there's no extra setup to do. It's really simple. Device ID makes no difference to this system. Yamaha ID, now this is important. So we need to set an ID which begins Y, 0, and then a hexadecimal number. I am going to choose Y00A and save. And that sets the Yamaha ID, and you'll see that changing in Dante Controller software at the same time. So the console relies upon that number for its control. Now let's move to Dante settings and open this menu. Device ID, that's just for information, and here we see the Y00A that we just set. Then network. This is the Dante network, and it needs to be in the same subnet as the control network. So again here, keep it on auto rather than manual, and we see a similar ID number there. And that is all we need to set, so we can exit the menus now. Now, one point to consider is the connections. We need two cables, one for the control and one for Dante, so they are separate. But if your device has two Dante ports, like some EM6000s do, then you can actually do a daisy chain like this. But still, you need two cables to connect to the network. Now, onto the console and see what we have to do here to get the control. Let's go to the I/O device menu and Dante Setup. Now here in the device mount page, we need to mount the EM6000. We can find it in the online device list. Okay, and it's now connected. Close that window, and in the Dante patch, we need to patch the channels from the mic receiver to the console. So we can choose some Dante channels here, find the EM6000 and make a patch. By the way, you see four channels here coming from the EM6000. It's actually two channels duplicated. Anyway, we only need to patch two. So that's done. Now we go to the wireless tab here, and we can see the EM6000 here and open this up to look at the information. We can see the name of the receiver, the frequency, the RX gain, which we can adjust here, mute, quality, RF level, and battery status. And look, we have a low battery here, and we're seeing the warning message. Now, if we go to the channel view, we should see this information in the channel view. So here it is up here. And if we look at a single channel, we can see it there. Open the pop-up, and we see all the information right in front of us. So that's it. Easy to achieve. CL and QL consoles are not just a great sounding mixer, They're also the centerpiece of an advanced control system.